About the potential of a chief of staff shakeup at the White House. So it wasn't a total surprise that there was a change earlier today. But here's the thing when it comes to the Trump White House. Now, the circumstances which everyone are working under there are beyond extraordinary and extraordinarily difficult. It is unlike anything the presidency has seen or faced before, at least in my lifetime. There are these five forces that are actively working to destroy, damage, delegitimize, and frankly, if they had their way, they want to run the president out of the office and overturn the election that you voted in. Now, there really is a swamp and a sewer in Washington, D.C. And of course, we start with the most dangerous. The most dangerous of all the actors against the president is the deep state. Look at this headline from Circa News' Sarah Carter, quote, exclusive, a top FBI lawyer, their chief counsel, allegedly under an investigation. Why? Leaking classified information to the media. So you have the FBI general counsel, their top attorney, now under investigation for leaking national security information to the media. And then, of course, you have the former director, James Comey, writing memos on government computers, classified information, we're told, removing that information and then having a friend leak it to the New York Times for a specific purpose to bring about a special counsel. And from there, the Trump administration has to deal with an unprecedented number of leaks. Get this, at a rate of more than seven times the previous two administrations the Trump administration has faced. 125 leaks, deep state leaks in 126 days. And what we know right now about the deep state is only the beginning of it. And look, the intelligence community is filled with really, really great good people that put their lives on the line. They love and they protect our country. We give them these incredible tools of intelligence so they can fight ISIS and radical Islam and Al-Qaeda and North Korea and Iran and Russia and China and all these countries that want to bring us harm. These people, they do an amazing job and they are truly patriots. But there's 0.1% in the intel community that have turned the tools of intelligence against you, the American people. They have unmasked Americans. We're learning more and more about that every day. They are leaking raw intelligence to the press. And had it taken now, it's taken so much time and so much attention for all these people that are working so hard to serve the president, his agenda, and to serve the country. And they've been dealing with us from day one. This needs to come to an end. Some people need to be indicted and put in jail for the crimes they're committing. Now, on top of that, one of the big forces against the president, we know the destroy Trump establishment media. People in this White House from day one have faced an abusively biased press that is obsessed with obscene conspiracy theories without evidence, Russia, Russia, nonstop. And it's taking up an enormous amount of people's time that work in the White House trying to serve the American people and advance the agenda. The media has only advanced that false narrative and they have ignored. Let's see, Debbie Wasserman Schultz, her IT guy, smashing hard drives, that scandal. Hillary Clinton's numerous scandal. Of course, she was involved in putting emails, classified, top secret, special access program information, on a private server that five foreign agencies picked up on. And then, of course, she destroyed 33,000 emails, and then she destroyed BlackBerries and iPhones with a hammer, and then she hands over to the FBI devices without SIM cards. Then her Uranium One deal, which is the most corrupt of all, a real Russia conspiracy. You have Loretta Lynch interfering in that email investigation. James Comey leaking to the press. The special counsel, Robert Mueller, his multitude of conflicts of interest. Then there's the obstructionist Democrats. Item three, they've got to fight. They don't want this president to succeed. Not one of them, no matter how small the issue, even if it benefits you, the American people. Their singular goal is to resist at every single turn, no matter what. They're actually giddy. They were giddy yesterday that healthcare failed last night. The very healthcare system that they sold to you on false and broken promises that raised your premiums up to $8,000 on average. Remember the promise, keep your doctor, your plan, save $2,500 a year? Yeah, put that in the bin heap scrap of history as one of the biggest lies ever told. You throw in the establishment Republicans. What happened last night was a disgrace. They don't want the president to succeed either. Look at the pathetic display from Senate Republicans this week. 7 years of promises, and they couldn't even pass the skinny repeal. John McCain over and over and over again promising repeal and replace. All the others that voted to repeal in 2015, they couldn't do it now. And then you got the never Trumpers. They never supported the president. Their only hope in life is that he fails, the country fails, so they can say, oh, I told you so. Ask yourself this. Has any administration, at least in our lifetime, had to deal with anything like this? I know I've never seen anything like it. This deck is stacked against the people that are working in the White House. And this onslaught of attacks from every part of the D.C. sewer and swamp, well, it has made it incredibly difficult for them in the White House to get their job done. And instead of focusing on the president's agenda, they spend 85% of their day fighting back against these five forces. Those are the conditions that Reince Priebus and everyone else in this White House has to endure every day since day one. It's a political war zone. Now, Reince Priebus can leave with his head held high tonight. He helped Republicans win the House. The